hails from the UAE. Let's welcome Rohit Iyengar, guys. Sorry about that. Hi, folks on Zoom. My name is Rohit Iyengar. And for heaven's sake, can people stop asking me to drop the accent? Ever since I've got to campus, people ask me if it's fake. And they think if they ask me enough times, I'll reveal my real voice. It's not the first time my accent got me into trouble, though. I'd once gone dress shopping with my parents in Amritsar. It's a beautiful city, but every time we went into a store, my parents asked me to keep my mouth shut. They thought that if the shopkeeper found out that we were not from India, he would charge us extra. Call it some kind of NRI tax, I guess. So anyway, my parents, they walk into the store all confident. I'm walking behind them, silent. So we go in and the shopkeeper starts showing us the dresses. This guy was like a ninja. He pulls them out. One, two, three. Before we knew it, there were like 20 dresses out. The game had begun. So he casually asks my parents where they're from. And my dad confidently replies, "Hey, hum to Bombay se aa rahe bhai." No, he didn't actually say that. He probably said something like, "Hum Mumbai se hai." So my parents have lived in the Gulf since the 90s. So they're not the most Indian people either. The shopkeeper realizes this and he turns to me. This guy was good. He played this game before. He knew his shit. He looks me right in the eye and says, "Beta, aap kaha se ho?" Boom! I'm standing there in silence. I didn't even have to open my mouth for him to know that he had won. He calls up his wife. He's like, "Hey, honey, aaj raat hum mutton khane wala hai, and the Saudis are paying for it." Well, you know what? The truth is, this is a fake accent. So, guys, for the first time ever, I'm going to reveal my real voice. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today, we will be doing the stand-up comedy. I will be telling the jokes and inshallah, you will be laughing. Otherwise, I will kill you! Anyway, I was born in Saudi Arabia, raised in Dubai. I worked in Los Angeles and now I am 5 minutes away from Hyderabad. To me, that seems like a straightforward explanation, but for some reason, most Americans don't get that. I was at a networking event in Los Angeles, and I was talking to a girl. Okay, wait, it wasn't a networking event, it was a club. The kind of club where girls have, what can I say, financial incentives to talk to you. For those of you that are very innocent, it's the one with the poles and they dance around. And in case, I think you look like you still don't get it, the girls take their clothes off. So the girl at the club, she comes up to me and is like, "Oh my God, you look so different. Where are you from?" After 4 years of answering these questions, I gave a short answer. "I'm from Chicago," which I thought would be the end of that line of questioning, but no. "But you don't look like you're from Chicago. Where are you like from?" I have two things to say about that. First, what is Chicago supposed to look like? You've got everyone from Kanye West to whiter than white chocolate Stephen Colbert coming out of there. And secondly, that's racist. There are so many Desis living in Chicago. They have a whole area called Little India with a road named, and I'm not making this up, Mahatma Gandhi Marg. It's right next to Muhammad Ali Jinnah Marg. And word on the street is they still don't know where one begins and where the other one ends. They're still fighting about that. So anyway, not wanting to ruin the mood, I explained the situation at the networking event, especially since I'd already paid for it. So I told her I was born in Saudi and I grew up in Dubai before moving here. To which she responds, "Oh my God, you're like an Arab." Now here's the thing. You know you've been single for too long when you've memorized the specials at the strip club. Mondays are 2-for-1 lap dances. Tuesdays are $50 off a private room. And on Wednesdays, get this, the girls, they dress up in saris and they dance to Sheila, Sheila Ki Giovanni. You should check it out. It's a fun time. So she tells me, oh my God, that's so awesome. You're like an Arab. At that point, I just gave up and told her, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. It's a pleasure to meet you. Thank you very much. That's my time. I'm Rohit Iyengar. Y'all have a good night.